Hey everyone, how you doing today? It is me, David, coming to you from my whiskey den here in Central Ohio. Hope everything's going well in your world. Things here are, I'm actually surprised things are kind of settling down a bit. Things have been crazy the last couple of years, actually, but settling down and kind of as I get bourbons new to me, feel, hey, let me just document and share that with you. So the videos are less frequent than they used to, but I'm still enjoying the bourbon, still enthusiastically enjoying the bourbon. So this, let me do a little pour of this. This is Black Dirt Distilleries single barrel bourbon. Black Dirt, New York, straight bourbon whiskey, out of Warwick, New York. So this is 116 proof, 58% alcohol. Now, this is not my bottle. A buddy of mine who lives in Dover, Ohio. Last spring, he and his family went up to upstate New York. He asked me, hey, have I ever heard of this? I'm like, no. So he bought a bottle and he enthuses over this bourbon. It's always about the Black Dirt bourbon. So saw him today. He lent me this bottle. I'm gonna see him next weekend, so I'll give him the bottle back. But he said, go ahead and do a video. Okay, so here we go. From what I've found, their typical mash bill on their bourbon is 80% black dirt grown corn, 12% malted barley, 8% rye. Now, up front, I'm not a huge malted barley fan of the flavor. In a bourbon, it does the job as far as what it's supposed to do. Give it kind of like a I'd say a scotchy kind of feel. So you get butterscotch or caramel overtones because of the sweetness of the corn and then the malted barley. At least that's how I understand it, based on my palate. So we'll see how it goes. Now, apparently, looking online about Black Dirt Distillery and their bourbons, their single barrels each have their own mash bill or something. I'm not quite sure. But what I just gave you is their typical mash bill. This is barreled for 5 years, aged for 5 years in the barrel. And let's see what we got out of this. It's kind of, the pressure's kind of on because, like I said, my buddy Dusty, hey Dusty, how you doing? Just is always enthusing over this bourbon. So now it's kind of high up here. I hope it lives up to the hype. So let's see. And if you are a regular viewer of the channel, wow, it does smell pretty good. Tell you in a second. I do enjoy these smaller independent micro distillery craft bourbon offerings, however you want to call it. The bottle actually reminds me of my, probably get from the same supplier, the MB Roland bottle up there. Plus, I don't really do single barrels here on the channel, unless it is from one of these independent distilleries. Then they usually specialize in single barrel selections, but usually those selections represent kind of what their flavor is all about. But single barrels can vary in proof, taste, all of the above. So this particular batch, this is barrel number 4829. This could taste different than barrel number 5003. So judging on this barrel, So we'll see what we get. It does, you know, I'm getting like this cherry tobacco type of overtone on the nose. There is no tobacco in this bourbon, just the ingredients I told you. But man, I'm getting cherries, which is interesting because I don't usually get those kind of notes. Yeah, I'm getting like cherry, tobacco. It reminds me, my dad, back in the 70s, they had these like little, they were like these cigarette looking cigars called Eric, Erik. I remember that because he was engaged to a woman. I wish he had married her, whose last name was Erickson. So I remember Erickson, Eric. Anyway, but that's what it reminds me of. They had a cherry flavor tobacco, cigar, cigarello, whatever. That this re I just remember enjoying smelling that cherry tobacco flavor as a kid. And that's what I'm getting. I'm getting a cherry tobacco. Man. All right, so let's see what we get on that. Out of my Glenlivet little glass. I love these glasses. I'm getting cherries. I'm getting kind of a, wow, that's nice. Cherries, a little bit of pineapple, tobacco, spice. It is a nice, well-balanced bourbon with a low percentage of rye in that mash bill. I'm getting a pepper, like black pepper spiciness. You're right, Dusty. Oh. Wow. Yeah, I'm getting what I was getting on the nose, I'm getting on the palate, and then some cherries, pineapple. You know what? Kind of like a fruit cocktail, but not in heavy syrup. Fruit cocktail in juice. Cherries, apples, pineapple, some grape, black pepper. Luxurious deliciousness. Now I'm getting a little bit more of that butterscotchy undertone in there. And a little, just a little tiny bit, just a little bit of maple. Man, Dusty, I wish you got a bottle for me. This is good stuff. Now, Warwick, New York. You might think, I guess technically it's upstate New York, but speaking of my dad, he had remarried somebody else and they had lived on Greenwood Lake, Northern Jersey. And so you go north over the border from Greenwood Lake, is Warwick, New York. So it's right on the New York, New Jersey border. Just really good bourbon. I mean, I'm very surprised. And, you know, at what I say, 116 proof, it doesn't have that harshness like this kind of high proof would have. It drinks more like maybe around 100 proof. So it's not harsh, it's not obnoxious. For the proof, it's pretty smooth. Really nice. Really nice selection. Black Dirt. This is a single barrel bourbon out of New York State, and I think when we're in that area, I'm gonna have to look for a bottle. Although I'm trying to be very selective as far as how much bourbon I actually have here, but this would be a fine addition to the collection. So there you go, Black Dirt Single Barrel New York State Bourbon Whiskey. Single, it does live up to my friend's hype. So until next time, it's me, David, coming to you from my whiskey den here in Central Ohio. I hope your next pour is your best pour. We'll catch you soon, and thanks for watching. Hey everyone, if you like what you see, please like and subscribe so you can be notified of future videos as they drop. Thanks for watching.